Hey guys, this is SB and welcome back today to another video inside of my awesome world. And as always, we're going to add a new fish to the fish tank. That's nice, isn't it? So we're going to go into this. We've got today, I can't even get through a door, you know, it's a challenge. Today, we've got a magenta teal Betty, okay? That is the fish that we're going to be adding to the tank. And before we go on, I just want to quickly say, make sure you are subscribed to this channel. You might be subscribed to my main channel and you'd love the series. But as it is continuing out on this channel, more SB, make sure you're subscribed to it. I just don't want you to miss any videos, you know, that would be a shame, wouldn't it, if you're missing videos. So make sure of that. We're going to add this magenta teal Betty. They're all dancing as usual on the little podiums. This guy's swimming about though, isn't he? But magenta teal, there we go. It's just learning its surroundings, I think, and it's going to enjoy it. It's going to enjoy it. So that's that. Yeah, picking up the pieces from last episode after we retrieved Fred, saved him. Everything's been fine since then. I've not heard anything from Armajolum. Fred's gone back to his challenge shack where he'll be much safer than in the nether. I mean, I don't know what he was thinking. So he's going to be much safer from attack in his little challenge shack. Look at that, a reward fish waiting for me. Now that is exactly what we want to be seeing. So if we just go and press this button, I mean, that's a challenge, isn't it? There we go. It's not the challenge of the day though, but we'll see what the challenge is going to be for my reward fish. So we'll go get scanned. Will be allowed through. Also, I've got loads of golden carrots now. As you can see, I got a stack. That's because, I had loads of spare from, like, I made loads of spare last episode, you know, in the Great Battle. But I'll explain what we're doing today later on. Good morning, Sean, by the way. How you doing, buddy? I didn't really, you know, I should give you say a proper hello. How you doing? Okay, you're blanking me. What are you looking at? I forgot. I need to put a painting on that wall for him, don't I? It's something for him to look at. Let's change the armor stand. There we go. Great, great dance moves there. Good morning, Miles the Mule. I get in trouble if I don't say hello to you, so good morning, Miles. And if we go over here, good morning, Fred. Back in business, back in your little place. So today's challenge is to MLG water bucket from 300 blocks. But I just saved you last episode. I thought you would give me an easy challenge. You know, maybe thanks for saving me. SB is a free fish like you normally do. No, you want to MLG water bucket from 300 blocks. I could die, Fred. You don't even care. A challenge is a challenge, though. I must do it for my reward fish, I guess. Man, he just doesn't care, does Fred, does he? He doesn't care, you know. I'm going to put my life at risk for a fish. Yeah, that's totally a great idea, isn't it? Okay, no problem, though. All right, I'll make it happen. I'm going to go and first get an elytra, and then I'm going to fly up loads and loads of blocks, and then I'm going to MLG with a water bucket. So we're going to need that. Let's put these elytra on. I'm going to go on my balcony, fly up, and then go from there. This is going to be quite a terrifying experience, but you know what? A fish is a fish, guys. We can make it. We can MLG. Whoa, look at this. Look at the elytra on this, by the way. So this is my new cape. And look at that. That's pretty nice. Yeah, I like that. Okay. I switched out my cape and it switched out. I like the way that the cape you wear is the elytra you wear. I think that's pretty cool. Right. So first of all, I want to find kind of a good area for MLGing. I feel like somewhere over here might be nice. So what do you say? MLG, go up 300 blocks. So what's ground level? Like 60? 66. So we need to go to 366 blocks up. That is a long, long way up. Let's have a munch while we're up here. Okay, oh, we're dropping. Keep going up, SB. Keep using firework rockets. Hey, what a waste of my firework rockets, eh? Right, so we're now at 300, okay. So what do I do? Do I just, you know, I'm going to go, I've gone a bit high here, but I'm going to be falling a little bit. Okay, I've taken my elytra off. All right. So I'm just going to hold left trigger and it should MLG. There we go. Yeah, you just have to hold it on Bedrock Edition to guarantee an MLG. Just literally hold your left trigger, hold your right click, whatever you use it. I mean, I guess it won't work on an Android device, but other devices, that's all you do and you are safe as can be. So that's quite good. It's a good reminder I know about these things, isn't it? You know, I could have died otherwise. Right, I want to fly back now. Can we do that? Okay, if we touch the water, apparently my elytra just disabled. I didn't work like that on Java, but this version it does. Okay, perfect. Right, we're off. Okay, I'm going to grab my reward fish and then we are going to have to do something else that I forgot to do when I was adding a fish to the fish tank. So we'll go grab that. I'm still not hungry at this point. Golden carrots are so good. I just don't get hungry. Oh, no, I did eat one in midair. Never mind. I take it back. So we're going to be building a way to get basically unlimited enchanted books. Because after last episode, I'm not having what happen again, okay? Like, we were kind of unprepared for a battle. We had to go to the nether, get netherite armor. We had to get the enchantments on that. I just don't want to have to do with that every time, you know? So today, we're going to be as well prepared as we can be. We're going to begin the preparations. Because Armajolum, I know I said don't return, but I feel like he's going to come back, you know? I just feel like it's the kind of thing he would do. He'll come back. He'll cause me more problems. So we're going to get well stocked up. I mean, all these emeralds, you'll say, we're gonna create like a proper trading area, but it's gonna be super simple. We're gonna create a villager breeder, which is one of the cutest things you're ever gonna see when we have loads of baby villagers around, and they all go to their own beds. It's the best thing ever, guys. Okay, I've tested it out. I'm actually really looking forward to building this. This is something I should have built a long time ago, like I guess over a year ago when they added the village and pillage update. I should have added this in, but I never did. Okay, and yeah, I feel like it's time I did. Okay, so I'm gonna go down here. I've got rid of the smokers here just because, to be honest, this machine doesn't work anymore. I think they fixed the glitches, although it kind of, the sand glitches now. So that doesn't really work anyway, but I've removed the smokers because they mess about with my villagers. So we're gonna go through here. Okay, you know what, cat, if you wanna come out, there you go. You know what, I'll keep the door open. So we've got, obviously, we've got the trays here. These guys, Fletchers, they sell me sticks. Well, I sell them sticks for emeralds. That's great. I can eat my reward. Whoa, just steady on. No fireworks inside, guys. That's definitely not a good idea. So you can eat my reward fish. And we are going to... Basically, I've kind of carved out the area. We've got to add more things to it just yet. But this is going to be my villager trading hall. So we've got a lot of items in here, you can see. We've got a lot of jobs things. So we're going to have a lot of people trading me books. And then other things that are going to be useful. I can get, like, unlimited food from a farmer and stuff like that. So we're going to be doing that. I've also got loads of beds for them because they're all going to be living in beds. So the way you got to do this is kind of particular though, okay? So we're going to create the villager breeder, which is going to be just a pretty easy thing, to be honest. We're going to need some stone for that. So I'm going to begin with that, actually. 1, 2, 3. So I think, yeah, the villagers are going to live on here. In fact, I think that's down one. Okay, yeah, they're going to live here. They're going to have a block like this. So basically, they're going to be in here. And the two villagers that are breeding are going to be here, and they're going to create baby villagers, and then they're going to go and live in here, grow up, and I'm going to use them to trade. So I've never actually created one of these before. I feel like I need to make an iron golem farm at some point, and this will be what I use as well. Just because, they changed the mechanics. So this is going to have bread in this dispenser. All right, we'll grab some dirt, I think, as well. And if we just get a bit of, let me see, what do we not need? We don't need these things at the moment, do we? So we're going to put some redstone on top like that, and we kind of need to. We just need to get into this wall, really. That's the only way I can say it. We need to get into this wall and get adding this. So we're going to add a little repeater. We'll add the repeater here, and then we're going to have that like that. So in this wall, yeah, we're going to have this just leading all the way to a lever through here. So, okay, we need to go a bit further in, though, if we're going to be doing this. So we're going to go along like this, dig down a bit more, just kind of work your way along. Where are we at here? Are we in a good spot? Let's have a look. Okay, we're a little bit low down, actually. Let me see. So I want one lever here. No, I want one lever. How do I want this? I know what I want. Okay. I don't want what I've built. I want one there, and because it's going to be two levers. So we'll have, let's see. We're going to go and put one like this. And this one is going to be the one that I've just built, I think. I think that's going to be the easiest option. If I go something like, yeah, let's do something like this, okay? This is kind of the only difficult part, kind of building the inner workings of the redstone. Once this is done, it's going to be all sorted, okay? So we're going to go and, there we go. Something like this, I think, is going to be best. I just don't want the wires to get crossed. You know, last thing you want in Minecraft, cross wires, okay? If you've got cross wires, you're in trouble. I'm going to have to mine this with a pickaxe. I've got rid of my shovel now. Right, so we'll go like this. Yeah, and then, oh, perfect, okay? That's just what's needed, okay? So I'm going to go and put some redstone just along here like this. Okay, that's going to connect up to that. And it should reach all the way in theory. Okay, we're going to see. We're going to test it out a little bit. So do we even have a lever on there? No, we don't. You know what? That's going to be a problem then if we've not got a lever on. So we'll go do this and it should dispense some bread. It didn't work, guys. Why didn't it work? Why does my things not work first time? You know, it's just, let's see. So the redstone, oh, okay, well, you know what? You'd have to be an idiot to make this mistake, and that makes me an idiot. Oh, well, at least it's a simple fix, you know? Okay, I just did it again. As I was saying, at least it's a simple fix, okay? There we go, the bread's out, okay? It worked, all right? I'm going to go and put the bread back in there then. Okay, so that's where the villagers are going to come. I also need a little system. I've actually put it, have I put it on the robot? I think I might move it, I think I might move it across one, actually. Yeah, let's do that. Let's move it across one. I think it's going to look better if it's across one. So, I mean, that shouldn't be a problem, but I think I'm going to go something like, let's just mine out this wall. Yeah, I'm going to put one there, that there. Okay, perfect. Alrighty, that is this bit completely done. Yeah, I might move it back across, honestly, because I kind of want that. You know what? We're going to keep it there. We can change it later, okay? Let's just stop being so particular over a tiny matter. All right, the other thing is we're going to need some pistons, okay? So these pistons are going to go into the ground like this. And this is going to be the way that the villagers... This is going to be like my little stop thing, you know, to stop the villagers escaping if I don't want them to, you know? If I want to keep these baby villagers trapped down here for a little bit, we've got that option. If I want to release them, I can just flick a lever and they'll all be released. So that's... I think that's a pretty necessary thing. So... Let me see. Oh, no. See, this is what I was afraid of, you know? Getting my wires crossed. Oh, no. Have I broke some more things? Right. Let's just check this all out, okay? So, that needs to be... Yeah. Okay. I think that's okay, actually. Maybe if I even just go back one. Yeah, if we just go into here, then that might solve the problem anyway. Okay. I'm going to go like this. And then like that. Alrighty. And we should be good. Okay. Hopefully everything works. And then just down here, yeah, if I go and place a redstone like this... And then we can just tunnel it down. Perfect. Look at that. Okay. Something's coming together. Okay. I'm not sure exactly if it's how it should be, but we'll work this out. I don't know. I know you guys didn't really want to come and watch me do redstone, but trust me, the rest of it is going to be the best thing ever. Okay. Once you see how this machine works, you're gonna be thinking, SB, you know what? It was worth watching you painfully try to do redstone, even though you've been doing Minecraft for I don't know how many years, a long time. You still can't do redstone, but yeah, trust me, guys. It'll be worth it. So I need to kind of chisel out a bit of an area here. All right, so we'll do all that. And is that every piston? Yep. So then what we'll do is we'll connect all this up. Pretty easy part of it. And then it just snakes around there. Okay, good stuff. And that is the redstone part complete. Now we probably need to go and get some villagers at this point. That's always an important part of creating something like this. You need the villagers. Let's see. So we just test it out. There we go. They're all up. And how does it look? Okay. It looks fine. You know, it could look better, but we'll just have to live with that. So there we go. How do I get out of here now? I'm trapped in my own trap. Okay, so that's all that set up. I'm also going to just put a little block underneath like that. So I need to get the villagers in. That's going to be something quite important. So we're going to just kind of bridge that up. Yeah. So this is the whole. There is it dark? Okay. I should probably sleep as well. I don't think I want any mob spawning. So I'm going to go and do that. I've realised I forgot to get a minecart as well, actually, now that I'm thinking about it. So that's a slight problem. Okay, some villagers decided to claim that bed. Not yet, okay? It's too soon. Yeah, I don't have a minecart and I need a minecart. I can't believe I forgot something so simple. So basically, let's just add some stuff. So the villagers are going to go in here, okay? This is where they're going to land. So if I go and... I need glass all around. So we're going to have a glass piece there. If we go like this, in fact, I'm going to make this a bit more secure as well. But this is where they're going to be, okay? They're going to live there. There's going to be trap doors around the side, okay? But we'll sort that in a moment. But what I need to do is actually box this all the way around for now, because otherwise they're going to be able to... The minecart's going to fall out, okay? And I don't want that to happen. All right. Trust me, I've tested this, guys, all right? I know what can and can't happen. So we're going to have... a trapdoor on each side, like, oh, not like that. Can I even fit it on here? I should be able to put it there, shouldn't I? If we go something like this, and then like that. There we go, perfect. Okay, same on this side. Okay, so that's going to make the baby villagers walk off. And we just need, we'll need a couple of beds, but I don't guess they're not too important at the moment. Yeah, I just need a minecart then, because they're going to be able to fall down there, no problem. So we need a little bit of iron. That's not a problem, okay? I'm sure I can find some. I mean, I have to go outside anyway, and I've got my elytra, so we can do some fast travel. Unfortunately, none of these guys are going to have iron. There's nothing really iron-related around here. So we're going to go out here. Look at this. The sun is shining. We'll go to my iron golden farm, which I think still has iron. It doesn't actually produce iron anymore, but I know it has iron anyway. So there we go. It's in here. So this is something that I need to change the design of to match Minecraft new state, basically. So I need two minecarts, so we'll grab 10 iron. Okay, perfect. Do I actually have a crafting table lying around? That's a good question, and the answer is I do. I was looking right at one as I asked the question. That was quite handy. Right, we'll go do this. Okay, give me those two minecarts. Thank you very much. Did it actually make them? Oh, I need to make another one. Okay, there we go. Okay, we've got two minecarts. Everything is in place, so I don't really need this stuff for now. Okay, let's try and fly again. Okay, it's always difficult off a little one. If I could press jump though, that would help. There we go. Perfect. Right, we're gonna go to my little creation down here. Look at this, a little little box, if you like. So this is where these guys live. Okay, yeah, you were under attack last night, I see. Oh, you've decided you want to be a Fletcher. Okay, I need to break that job site block. I need to remember to do that. So what I'm going to do is place a couple of minecarts. Okay, that's it. You get into that one. You go in that one. Don't be like this. Come on. I feel like if I open it, he's going to run away. So I've got to be quite careful. I can break this one because that's not an issue. Okay. And I need to put a rail down. So we'll go and place that like that. Alrighty. You, sir, you can be the first one. You've been well behaved, so there you go. You don't do this to me. Okay? I will rebuild the track if I have to. It's not gonna be that simple though, is it? I wanna punch you, to be honest, but I think that might be a bad idea. Let's see. Okay, I tricked him. As you can see, he tried to follow me. And I tricked him into it. Right, we'll go like that. There we go. Now, you will not escape. Okay, so this next bit is kind of a tricky task because we've got to break them out without letting them out, okay? Which it could go wrong, honestly. Can I just dig my way down here? It's going to save me going around, isn't it? Right. I don't want to hurt them either. That's also a worry. Okay, I think if I go something like... if I break the... Oh, I don't know. If I break the top one first and then the bottom. Yes, that's how you do it. The top one, then the bottom one. Okay. And now we'll just go and grab ourselves. Well, we'll go and get rid of this dirt. There we go. All right. They're in. Ha ha. You are now in my machine. We will go like this. The water should all flow perfectly. Look at that. It does. Okay. Now, I don't want you guys to be Fletchers. We're going to make you into fishermen, actually, because it doesn't really matter what I make you into, as long as I make you into something. So we're going to go and place that there. Okay, I've got to go. I don't really like the way that barrel's the wrong way around, but you know what? That's it now. That's the design. The barrel's going to be that way around. If we don't like it, we're just going to have to... I can't be bothered to break it and replace it. Right, I need to break this. There's a missing Fletcher. I don't know what happened to him, but he's gone, so... you leave any job site blocks remotely near any place on Bedrock and somebody will claim it. A villager will. That's why I had to delete all my smokers that are miles away. It's a bit of a stupid thing, but they should both be fishermen now. Are they both fishermen? Let's see. Yeah, they're both fishermen. Perfect. So what we do, all we have to do now is literally just give them some bread, I think. Oh no, they're going to need some beds first, actually. They're not going to do this. So they're going to need their own beds first. So we're going to go and put those just here like that. There we go, and we'll put another one. I want to make this bit slightly nice, you know. So, there we go, a bed each. Okay, so what on earth are you doing it? Well, you know what, we're not gonna be upset with you. So I think they've claimed those beds. And then, if I add a load more beds, that's when they're going to start to breed. So, let's see. That should have given them some bread. Did it give them bread? Okay, oh, my dispenser doesn't work. no, what did it do? What did I do wrong now? I must have crossed the wires again or something. Let me just check. But once this is done, they will start breeding. And then you know we'll be sorted. I think it doesn't reach far enough. Is that right? It's too far away. Yeah. To be honest, I don't really want. Yeah. You know, I need to. Tell what I'll do. I will move the repeater back one. I don't know why I'm so against the repeater just moving ever so slightly back. So if I got like that, there we go. Okay, and then we just put some redstone in. All right, now you will get your bread, guys. Okay, stop complaining. Your bread is on the way. So we'll go like that. Okay, so now I just have to flick this up and down a few times. This will give them a bunch of bread. They don't need much bread. They need like 3 bread or something to breed. And then they just need more beds, okay? Because, you know, they've got to repopulate a village. So we add these. It should work. This Enderman is freaking me out, so I'm going to get rid of him as well. Let's get an axe on him. Oh, you teleport away. I should have put him in the back. Oh, he's back. He's picking up my dirt blocks. Is he gone? I think he's gone. Right, as you can see, now they are breeding. Okay, perfect. So, a baby villager is going to do this. So, we're going to go like this. Alrighty. And we should... They only do this during the day, by the way. But we should get a baby villager any moment now. There we go. We've got a little baby. So, this is the first of my employees. Yes, employees. Not slaves. Employees, okay? So, the best thing is going to happen later on as well. But you'll have to wait and see for that. I want to add some glass to all of this. So, we're going to go and... make it all look nice and fancy. We need to wait for them to grow up, you see. So But in the meantime, we can, while we're waiting, okay, they should keep breeding me more as well. I'm going to put a clock here because you kind of need to know when it's night and dark as well so that you can let them go to bed. So they've got enough bread still. They're still happy to breed. I'm now stuck down here again. Oh, no, if I let you out, oh, this is going to be a... Okay, here's what we've got to do. There we go. You didn't escape. You live down there for the moment, mate. So we're going to make some space and we're just going to get all these beds down as well. I think that's going to be a good idea. So we'll go clear all this room. There we go. You know what? That'll do. Let's just get all 9 down. Okay. So yeah, basically you want to have all this. Now, this is the best way I found. I found there is a way to do it where they're all next to each other, but Bedrock's so buggy that I found that if I've split them up, then it's just a much safer way of doing it. It causes less problems further down the line. So we'll go and grab these final ones and we'll get ready to put some glass in. I also want some dirt as well. That's going to be useful. So we'll go to this. Already we've got a cat. This cat has decided this is enough of a village for it to spawn. Alrighty. So yeah, if I put just some nice glass all the way around, there we go. Perfect. So you may think that what I'm about to do is a little bit mean, but I don't think it is. So this is where they're all going to live. Okay, this is their homes. Okay, they're not free roam because that's just going to make things hard work for me. So we're going to go and put that like that. Okay, perfect stuff. Okay, we've got another one. You know what? Let's give them more bread. That's it. We need 18 of them. Okay, yeah, that's right. No messing about. So as soon as it gets dark, which it's not too far away, that's where the magic's going to happen. I can't actually start putting down these job site blocks in this chest until it gets... Oh, you're back, are you? With another dirt block. Oh, he's gone. Yeah, I can't start putting down the job site blocks until any of these grow up. They take a little bit of time to grow up, but I just want to show you something really cool when it gets dark. There's another baby village. You're going to think this is the cutest thing. It's honestly worth waiting for. I'm not even going to take a cut because it's going to happen any moment now. It is going to be dark enough for them to go to sleep, so I'm just going to wait until it happens. I'll actually know when they're going to sleep because in here they're going to all be asleep in here. Oh, you're not quite in bed yet, are you all? Oh, I need to break this bed as well. Actually, I just realised somebody's going to... Oh, I might have messed everything up. I might have screwed everything up here. I think I might have screwed... I'm going to have to break all the beds, aren't I? Yeah, it's so stupid, but I think I'm going to, just to be safe, I'm going to have to break all the beds because otherwise the villagers in there are going to claim one of these beds and then the new villagers won't want to claim it. It's a stupid thing, but they don't go for the nearest bed. They go for any bed anywhere near. And I think because it's complicated, but because they will have claimed the bed... Oh, you're back. Get out of it. Because they will have claimed the bed outside there that was spare, they probably, like, when I broke it, claimed one of these yellow beds rather than the blue beds over there. So I've got to break this, but this is a good opportunity for me to... I've just realised I need to plug up the hole above them as well. They're going to die otherwise. They're going to have something drop in and get them. I need to be quick here. I didn't think about that. Let me just create some sort of safety thing for you guys. Don't worry, this is a life-saving thing I'm about to do. You know, let's just get on with that. There we go. Okay, it is now dark, so any moment now I can do the good thing. So I can do the thing that is amazingly funny. I'm going to try and jump out of here as well without causing any problems. So that's safe, okay? I need to... Once I've redone the beds, I don't even need to redo all the beds. I just need to break them all. So we'll just go like this, okay? Break the beds. And I feel like you guys seeing this and how it works though might be helpful for you because you don't want to screw anything up. I hope this works. It's possible that it doesn't work. And one of them wants to go, but I think they would try or get over there. So, let's see. Oh no, it's him. He wants that bed. No. Okay. This could be a problematic situation here. You need to like this bed, which means, right. Okay. See, the thing is, right. You guys come up. Okay. Any of you gonna accept these beds? Let's see. Some of them have got to be claimed. So this is not as I was wanting it to be, but look at them. They just go into their bed. They just know what they're doing. Is this guy going to... I think this guy wants one of these beds, maybe. If I break these, if I can get him to go into a bed, but these guys are going to claim it before. I have to do some bed shuffling around, basically. It's stupid, okay? So this guy down here, where's he at? Okay, he's just in there. So if I keep placing beds till he gets in one, then that's gonna work, right? So he's not getting in that one. Okay, this is how you do it though. You've got to do it one bed by at a time. So is he gonna get in this one? No, that's claimed by the other villager. The adults get it first. Okay, this guy, he wants that bed. There we go, look at him. Such a well-behaved little fella. All right, I need to do this. Okay, and then what we do, in fact, I'm gonna do this with dirt for now because I don't want, because I'm gonna have to break this. And you know what, we do it with glass, it looks nicer actually. There we go. They're in there now. They're in there. So if I now break these beds, this is the way to do it, guys. Okay. You know, if you're troubleshooting it, break these beds. Okay. Now these guys are going to accept these two beds again. Okay. And okay. There we go. All right. You've got your beds. Are you happy now? Yeah. I screwed up by leaving an open bed back through there. So that's my own fault. But yeah, they're going to sleep in here. We're going to need more baby villagers. We're going to need enough to fill this entire place up. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut ahead. I should probably sleep as well. So let me do that. I'm going to cut ahead when I have created all of the, well, all the villagers that I need are here basically. Okay, because it's going to be quite a few needed. Yeah. So we've got plenty of baby villagers. What we're going to do now is go ahead and release them and let them all go to bed. This is the cutest part. Okay. Look at them all. Look at how well behaved they are. All going to bed. Look at them. They all know where their home is. Okay. They're all jumping into bed. That one there doesn't seem to know. Okay. That's it. Get into bed. Okay. All of you. That's it. Look, it's just amazing. Look at him. I just think it's the coolest thing ever. So we've almost filled the slot. That's it. What are you doing being so late? Come on. Get to bed. What's it? That's his bed. Is there no space for you? Come on. There's got to be room for you somewhere. What's wrong with this bed here? Don't tell me that it's not worked out for you. And they've claimed it. And they keep producing more baby villagers. I mean, that's it. You go to bed. There's two beds left. Okay. So... okay, now he's floating along. It's a bit glitched, but yeah, that should be all the beds filled up. So I need to kind of get them all blocked in. So we're just going to place all this like so. So now these are all going to be trapped in their the correct beds, though. That's the main thing. Cat, do you want to live with this? Is there even I don't know if there's a baby villager in this one, but we're going to go like that. Okay, sometimes the baby villagers actually go invisible, so it's hard to tell if there is or there isn't, because I think some of these beds do have baby villagers in. They go invisible. You have to reset the game to find them. So, and to be honest, I can probably test actually by trying to get in the bed. Maybe let's try that. Okay, so if I try and get in this bed, let me see. Okay, so that bed is this one's currently empty. So let's go like that. Okay, what about there was another one. Yeah, this one too far away. Let's see. This bed is also... no, wait, this... I think that actually just made somebody mad. The thing is, yeah, you get the invisible villagers problem, which is just super, super annoying. Let's see about this bed. Okay, I feel like somebody was in that bed as well because they got the annoyed particles. Let's go with this bed. Okay, yeah, again, I got the annoyed particles. Maybe they're all full. What I'll have to do is I just have to wait and... wait and see. I think if I reset the game, sometimes that fixes it. So I'm gonna try that. Okay, I think it worked to show most of them. I don't know what this guy's doing out of bed. You should be sleeping, mate. It's still nighttime. But what I'm gonna need to do now is start working on the job stations part of things. So yeah, because if I don't place, I think this little baby must have got into bed now, surely. Yeah, if I don't start doing this, like there's gonna be too many and they're all gonna mix up job sites. So this is kind of the only way to do it. So what I do is I will place this here. Okay, which one of you is gonna use it? I don't actually know. One of them's used it, and I don't know which one. So this is like, I mean, villagers are just so broken on Bedrock that it makes this very annoying. But it's definitely a worthwhile thing. Let's see. Okay, that guy's likes that job site. So if I break, let me see. So which guy likes this one then? There's only three adult villagers at this point, so you're kind of best to do them as they grow up, and then it's straight away. There must be an invisible one, maybe. Is it this guy? I have no idea. Let me see. Okay, it was you. You liked it, right? So if I go place that there. This guy decides that he's a wise guy. All right, well, you know what we'll do? We'll break this one and then we'll place it here. And he will use it. There we go. Perfect. Okay, that worked. And then this one, you've got to just kind of find out the order. And then this one. Right? Yeah, okay. So I'm going to just keep an eye out on them. Make sure none of them grow up. And that's how we're going to do it. So, oh, we've got a baby villager in here as well. Perfect. So we'll go and block that up. Okay, all the cats decide that that's the bed they want to lie on. So there you go. We only need one more baby villager now. And we've filled it up. So what I'm going to be doing now is... I don't know whether to wait till day, actually. I might just go and sleep and then... Let me flick this up. Let me sleep, and I don't think there's a baby dungeon in that one. There's not one in this one, right? There might even have been one, I don't know. But I'm gonna sleep, and then we can start with the next phase of the plan, and that is to get myself some good trades. So we're gonna go like this, okay? And what we'll do is on these guys, we will just keep breaking this and replacing it until I get the enchantments that I want. Oh, did I? No, he can't get out, can he? Okay, good. Right, so yeah, we just keep doing this, and eventually he's going to give me some really good like book enchantments and stuff, and that's what I'm going to be using. So I've set up quite a few trades for these guys. I will need to get some signs to add. There's a few more here that I need to do. So what I want to do though before I go any further is actually lock them into their trades. So if I go and grab some books, because I don't want them to like change their trades, which can happen. But if you trade with them, it locks them in. So you know, I have a lot of junk. Let's go and chuck a load of this in the chest, and then we'll go from there. So yeah, let's just clean up my inventory a little bit, because there's going to be a lot of emeralds in my inventory in a moment, okay? I have a lot of emeralds in my treasure room. I do plan on repopulating that room, but for now we're going to do this. And we're going to have, okay, we've got loads there. That's pretty good. So then if we go, let's see, so this guy, what was his trade? Let me just see, it was Fire Aspect 2. So if we click that, we get that, perfect. If we go and let's see what this one was. This is Mending, so I get a Mending book. Good stuff. What else have you got? You are a Infinity. So Infinity is going to be useful for bows. We've got ourselves Unbreaking 3. That is going to be very, very much used a lot. We've also got... Oh, this is my Sharpness 5. Look how cheap that is. 25 emeralds for Sharpness 5. This is pretty good. And all the other ones... Did I already trade with you? Let's see. Respiration. No. I think Respiration 3 is max. So we'll go with that. We can use one of these chests here. So we'll just go and... This can be used for Enchanted Books just for now. So they're all locked in. I got to just lock in all these, well, get trades for these new guys. So all I'm doing is basically placing this down and seeing who reacts to it. So it's this guy here. So he's the next guy, you know. It's just a system you have to do. So this is the guy that I'm now going to keep doing this to, and he'll keep using this job site block now. So let's have a look. It's very fiddly seeing it. I'm only in Breaking 2. So this takes a bit of time, but once it's set up, like, it's set up forever, so... You know, I'll have all of the perfect things. So I'm going to continue until I've got all of these villagers set up with trades that I'm happy with. I'll probably be signposting it in between episodes rather than straight away. But yeah, let's get all this set up. So I've done quite a lot of them, got some really good enchantments. I'm going to finish this in between episodes because it's going to take some time and wait for them to grow up. So I think some of them have gone invisible. They are here, you just can't see them. It's a bug. I'm sure they'll fix it on Bedrock eventually. But they're all in there. I don't know if they're all going to become librarians. I have other job site blocks. Whether I'll use these or I might extend it and do it with that. Or I might extend it and then use those new villagers for different ones and just use librarians for now. I don't even know where. Maybe there wasn't a lectern. So yeah, good enchantments. We're going to have some really good stuff. We're going to have all the good stuff that we need. I mean, look already in this chest. We have got some really good stuff. I mean, look at this. And this is going to be unlimited. And I'm probably going to turn one of these into a zombie villager and cure it. And then I'll get super cheap trades from the one that got cured. But I think all the other ones get discounted as well. I may even trigger a raid to get even more cheap stuff. We're gonna get one of the best deals we can. I mean, already we're getting pretty good deals. I mean, look at this. What's this guy offering? Yeah, for Sharpness 5, 25 emeralds. That is so cheap. It's like usually 50, 60 emeralds on the other version, on Java. So I'm looking forward to this. I'm going to have the best stuff. We are going to be ready the next time we need to battle Imer Jolem. And we are not going to cut out. We're running out of armor. This is something I should have done a long time ago. But yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys. Hopefully you enjoyed. Leave a like and subscribe if you did. And hopefully I'll see you guys next time.